In an August 2021 journalistic mission, retired U.S. Army Major General Mark McCarley traveled to Armenia and the Artsakh Republic, leading a team that included retired U.S. Army Colonel Robert Cassidy, American-Armenian investigative reporter Apo Jabarian, and cinematographer Aaron McCarley. Their August visit was the first by Western journalists to the Artsakh Republic in 2021.
When we arrived and we began our conversations with senior officials, both in the Ministry of Defense and in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, and we were quite explicit and straightforward with those senior officials, and it was that we had a mission. We wanted to assess what took place a couple months earlier, and we also wanted to come forth with sort of a study, which we would share, as to what could be done thereafter, here and thereafter, to support Armenia and Artsakh in what we called the maintenance of the security. And I think that that message resonated. And these senior officials, after confirming our credibility, and I think that that was very important, that we were not over there as some sort of a recreational mission, but this was truly a team of individuals with real background in the military sciences, in journalism, and in film.
In an effort to follow through on its primary mission, ANSI's second educational and journalistic mission deployed to Armenia in July 2022. Led by retired U.S. Army Major General Mark McCarley, retired U.S. Army Major General Scott Eflint, and American-Armenian investigative journalist Apo Jabarian. Upon arrival at the Zvartnots Airport in Yerevan, the capital of Armenia, they were greeted by a delegation made up of government officials, members of the Armenian parliament, and civic leaders. The following day, they were escorted by the Republic of Armenia military police, provided by the Ministry of Defense. At the Armenian Defense Ministry, the ANSI team of journalists was accompanied by the Armenian Defense Attaché to the United States, Colonel Arman Mkrtchyan, and ANSI benefactors Dr. and Mrs. Vagarshuk and Silva Pelosyan. All were greeted by Armenian defense officials. They were given a warm welcome by Army Deputy Minister of Defense, Mr. Arman Sarkisyan. During their meeting, they were educated on Armenia's national security challenges. The ANSI team of journalists had an insightful meeting with Mr. Levon Ayvazyan, head of defense policy and international cooperation at the Department of the Ministry of Defense. During their educational and journalistic mission to Armenia, retired U.S. Army General Mark McCarley and retired U.S. Army Major General Scott Eflint visited St. Sarkis Church in Yerevan, a source of spiritual motivation to continue support for Armenia. The following day, General McCarley and General Eflint paid homage to the martyrs of the Armenian genocide of 1915 to 1923, accompanied by the Republic of Armenia Defense Attaché in the United States, Armenian Army Colonel Arman Mkrtchyan. General McCarley and General Eflint also visited the Armenian Military Cemetery in Yerablur, just outside Yerevan. The ANSI team also met Major General Gennady Tavartsyan of the NDRU, the National Defense Research University of the Republic of Armenia, the equivalent of the U.S. Army War College. The ANSI team then paid a working visit to Republic of Armenia's only Armenian Peacekeeping Forces Brigade, trained to NATO standards, at its headquarters just outside of Yerevan. The following day, the ANSI team was escorted by Armenian military personnel to the front line, the most recent point of military engagement between Armenian and Azeri forces, at an undisclosed location in Sunig, where the combatants are separated by sometimes no more than 300 meters. Members of the ANSI team were given unprecedented special access to Armenian Army defense positions and its brave soldiers. These positions had been subjected to almost nightly shelling and small arms fire since the end of the 44-day war. 2 months later, in September 2022, the Azeris again crossed the line of contact to attack these very same Armenian bunkers and trenches. They were guided by the Republic of Armenia defense attaché in Washington, D.C., Colonel Arman Mkrtchyan. The ANSI team also familiarized itself with various underground military foxholes in undisclosed locations in southern Armenia.
Great opportunity, Apo, to assess the challenges that the Armenians face with the adversary that has so far caused death and destruction to thousands of the Armenian people. So we came out here, studied, did some analyses, and we hope what we've done benefits Armenia in its quest to remain a sovereign nation.
Who do you have as part of your team?
To my left is Brigadier General Chris Spillman. He's an air defense expert. And to his left is John Kim, Major General John Kim. And he was former commandant of the Army's senior educational institution, the Army War College.
Could you tell me more about General Spillman? And are you all retired?
Yes.
General Spillman, could you please share with our TV viewers about your experience so far in Armenia?
It's been a very educational experience for me. I've never been to Armenia before. But the big takeaway for me is the passion that the Armenian military has for the defense of their nation and the professionalism that they've exhibited and have witnessed during this trip.
General Kim?
Yeah, hi, John Kim. And really been an amazing trip. Also my first time to Armenia. And I think one of the things that's very different from the United States Army, we're playing the way game. We're in other countries usually doing things. Here, the Armenian military has to work so closely with the citizens, and there's no space, right? No matter what you do, you're impacting each other. So defending the homeland is so hard when your borders are not secure, it's dangerous. So I really appreciate the way the people we met, both civilian and military, were really all working together to try to help Armenia.
Could you please tell our viewers, share with our viewers about your activities before your retirement?
I was the commandant of the United States Army War College, and it's my last job. And then a series of other jobs as a general officer, and then 35 years in the Army total.
Thank you. And General Spillman?
I commanded Army Air Defense Artillery Forces in the Middle East. Before that, I was the commandant of the Air Defense Artillery School. And I retired in 2019 after almost 38 years of active duty military service.
And General McCarley?
Spent most of my career in the Army as an Army logistician, commanded at all levels of the Army logistics areas, and ended up as the Deputy Chief of Staff for TRADOC, the Army's Training and Doctrine Command.
So far, how many of similar educational missions have you conducted and led as chairman, as founding chairman of the American Armenian National Security Institute?
Mr. Chairman of ANSI, this is the third one.
Would you qualify this third mission as a moderate success?
It's an absolute success. I'm going to make it real quick. Absolute success.
Does ANSI's message of support for the defense of Armenia resonate in America? Among other voices, ANSI's educational message and its efforts to enhance American-Armenian security cooperation are now being heard in Washington, D.C., and hopefully with a good number of the American people.
We are at a critical moment for the future of Armenia and Artsakh, and it will take U.S. support to ensure that that future is a secure one. And so that is why I'm so glad to have an organization like yours dedicated to educating other members of Congress and leaders in government about the importance of standing by the U.S.-Armenia relationship.
What else is ANSI focusing on?
Recently, U.S. Army Major General, retired Mark McCarley, the founding chairman of the American Armenian National Security Institute, AANSI, made a very important announcement on the formation of the AANSI Humanitarian Support Brigade to Armenia and Artsakh.
Now, the second big objective
for 2023 for ANSI is to put forward about 40 to 100 young, perhaps not so young, men and women from the United States, Armenian Americans, non-Armenian, but patriots who support Armenia in its efforts to defend its borders and to spread democracy, and to deploy these young people to Armenia for training. The training's about a week or so, and at the training facility, they'll learn such things as first aid, mass casualty care, response and recovery, infrastructure rebuilding. That means that if something were to go wrong, either a natural disaster such as an earthquake, which Armenia often experiences, or another attack from its enemies, America will be present with its young members of the ANSI Humanitarian Support Brigade. So this whole evening tonight is about putting together people from all walks of life. All of you who have attended this banquet in person or are witnessing this banquet virtually, and is about raising the money necessary to accomplish these objectives. As most of you probably know, ANSI takes absolutely not a penny from either the Republic of Armenia or the United States government. This gives us the freedom to do what we believe is absolutely important to pursue and succeed in our objective of maintaining the security of the Twin Republics and advancing democracy in that part of the world. Thank you again for your participation.